Hello students, yesterday we have just ended the topic, that is eddy currents, and there for the eddy currents we have seen how they are produced, what is the reason behind the production of them, and how can we minimize the effect of the eddy currents. And later we have seen the undesirable and the application of the eddy currents, so number of applications we have seen there. So I think now you are able to understand where it is undesirable for us and where we can utilize the eddy currents production. Next topic here for the electromagnetic induction chapter that we have to study today, that is self induction topic. So what is the self induction? Let's understand this one. So the self induction is, before just going to understand it or just define it, I will again try to remind you the topic that we have studied up to now. So we have started our chapter from the electromagnetic induction, from the topic magnetic flux. So this is the whole, you can say that the key point of this chapter is magnetic flux. If you are able to understand that factor, then how the flux is changing, how can we change it, why EMF is generating here, everything is possible to understand here. So simply, whenever the if you will see the flux, whenever it is changing, then due to change in flux, energy is changing, and that energy induces some induced EMF and current inside the coil, means a production of the current and voltage we can see by the change in flux. And by change in flux, we know that we can do it by the three methods, either by changing magnetic field or magnetic field lines, you can say that. Secondary, by changing the area of the loop. Third, by changing orientation of the loop with respect to the magnetic field. So all these phenomena and how the production of the induced EMF, and what is the formula to calculate the induced EMF producing by these all methods, we have seen that. So now to understand the self induction, here, as you know that whenever the current will pass through any circuit, then that current will set up magnetic field around it, and if magnetic field around it is set up, then obviously there will be some magnetic flux associated with that coil in which the current is flowing. Whenever the current will change here, so if current will change, then with change in current, the magnetic field produced by that current will change, and due to the change in field, there will be change in flux link with the coil, and that flux gives rise to production of the induced EMF, or here induced current, and that will be in back direction to the current there, that is passing through the circuit. Means it will oppose the cause, and here the cause is the flow of current, so it will try to oppose, and this induced current will set up in opposite direction, and the direction you can understand easily by Lenz's law. So this phenomena is known as self induction. Means in the coil, the induced EMF is induced by itself, or the change in current itself gives rise to the induced EMF in its own circuit. This is called self induction process. Means here, if suppose we have some kinds of coil in such a way, and in these coils we have just connected it by some battery, and here a key we have just attached with it. Now we will just tap this key here, and then obviously by this battery we can just provide some current through it. Now this I current is flowing. When this current will start to flow in this coil, then this coil will develop a magnetic field around it, and magnetic flux will be associated with it. So suppose phi is the magnetic flux at that time. Now if we will change this current that is flowing by using some rheostat, you can do it. So if we will change the current, suppose we have changed the current from di plus di, so obviously this current will change the magnetic field linked with this coil, or magnetic field produced in this coil. So it means that if magnetic field is changing, then you know that phi is given by ba cos theta. So from here, as b is changing, then phi will also change. So here this phi will change according to the change in magnetic field. So as the flux is changing here with time, then obviously that change in flux will gives rise to an induced EMF given by the Faraday law of electromagnetic induction, and direction is given by Lenz's law. So its direction is set up in this whole circuit in the opposite direction of the current here. so that it can minimize this current and it can oppose its own cause here. So this phenomena of the production of induced EMF or current in the own circuit by change in current, it is known as self-induction. So I think self-induction is now clear. We can produce such kind of current obviously in such a way also. Now here if you will see the change in flux here, that is directly linked with the change in current here. Means for the self-induction phenomena, the change in flux phi, that is directly proportional to the current flowing in it. So we can just write down, or in the case of proportionality constraint, we can induce here, that is phi is equal to Li. So this L is known as coefficient of self-induction. So this is very important term, as like we have understood the term capacitance, inductance, such that it is the, sorry, not cap, inductance, capacitance, resistance. So in the same way here, the any inductor that we are calling any coil in which current is flowing, and due to that there is change in flux, and due to that self-induction process or induction process we are getting. So that kind of device is known as inductor here. So this property tells us about the inductor property or self induction phenomena or electromagnetic induction. So this is very important term to understand any coil whenever we are using it to, in the induction process here. So this is called coefficient of self-induction. And here if in our coil there are n number of turns, so for n number of turns, you know that in each, if in every turn I current is flowing, then in n turn the number or total current will flow n I. So here we can write it n L I. Clear? Simply here this formula, that is important for us that we can understand. Now we can also convert this one in the terms of induced EMF. So induced EMF, as you know, this is given by Faraday law of electromagnetic induction, and according to this, this is the induced EMF formula. So if you will write the value of phi here, so this is equal to ddt of L I. And L is the proportionality constraint, so if this is, we can take it outside, then this formula will be equal to minus L di by dt. So from here we can also calculate what will be the induced EMF that is generated due to change in current here. So you can see that induced EMF is also directly linked with the current change in current. Means if current will change in at large amount, then there will be large induced EMF in opposite direction. This negative sign tells us that this induced EMF will be generated in opposite direction. This will give rise to a current in opposite direction. So I think this is now clear. And next one, if you have to just find out the unit of the induced self-induction, then you can just find out from here. And basically its unit we are just noted in the terms of Henry. So by to give the honor to the scientist Henry, we are using such kind of here units. So students, in next one we will see some experimental evidence to understand the self-inductance phenomena here. How can you understand the self-inductance phenomena? So for which I will display a video, and I will just explain you how we can understand and observe the self-inductance phenomena. So here as you can see in this figure, we have seen or we have taken a coil that you can see from here. So in this coil here a LED is attached with it. So with the help of this LED, we can understand if there is the production of any kind of EMF or not here, or whenever the flux change with this coil, then whether there is induced current or not. So whenever you will get the induced current through the flux changing in this coil, then that time it will predict us that in the coil induced EMF or induced current is generated due to the change in its own coil. So this is the phenomena of self-induction. And for this one, as we have used LED, then whenever current will be will flow through this circuit, then this LED will blow up. So let's see this experiment now. So for this experiment, as here you are seeing this coil, definitely number of turns are here in this coil, and here the two ends of the LEDs are just connected with the coils at two ends here. So here by change in the area of the coil, or here you can see the spark in the LED. Now we are going to use this source of circuit here, so that in the coil current can be produced. So as initially here the circuit is not connected, then that time, as you can see, there is no change in the LED here because no flux change we are getting here. But means initially the flux is zero, but now when we will just see here, by using these two wires we can see current is flowing whenever we are connecting these two wires, and spark is generating. So now we will use these two wires to complete the circuit and to flow a current through it. So that current we will utilize, like you can see that there is the flow of current. Now if we will use this current inside this coil, such kind of things you are seeing here, a spark we have generated. Now you have to see the phenomena of LED lights that is generated here. So LED is blowing up whenever we are completing this circuit. Now in dark you can understand it in more clear way. Let's see it. Yes, you can now see that with connection of the circuit, means here as we are changing the current in the circuit, then with change in current we can see there is the So as you have seen the practical application, practical and experiment on the self-inductance process. So as in video you have seen that we have used a coil, and around that coil we have just generated or changed the current there, and due to the change in current at flux linked with the coil, that will changes, and due to that there is a production of induced EMF and induced current that lighten up the LED that we have attached to the coil. So let's see that behavior of the experiment by theory, and you can understand after that the experiment fully. So suppose this is the coil that we have taken there, the rounded coil that we have taken, and with this rounded coil we have attached an LED here in this way. So two ends of the coil we have attached with some LED lights here. Or you can see this is the bulb also. You can take anything here. So this is our coil. And one more thing, this coil, basically we try to take it to as a choke coil. So choke coil are basically that kind of coil that are insulated coils exactly. So this is same as just like the solenoid, but they are insulated as well. So here as this coil we have taken, our LED we have connected. So initially when we will connect these all things, as there is no current present in the coil, so there is no current flow through the circuit and LED will not blow up. But the first things we have seen in the experiment. But when we just connect it, or we will generate some of the current inside the circuit. So for this one we have taken a battery, and suppose a tapping key I have just connected with it. And we can also connect rheostat to this one circuit here. So for this one experiment here, now you can see for this coil purpose, this is LED, this is our battery. Now if when you will initially you are not tapping the key, means circuit is open, then that time again for the open circuit, as LED does not blow up. So as that we have seen also in experiment. But when we just connect this tapping key here, means the circuit, like you have seen two wires that we have seen. So suppose they are just like the tapping key, or we can attach here the tapping key and the two ends of the wires that can be attached to the tapping key there. Or directly you can connect these two portions of the wire here, like we have seen in the experiment here. So when we will connect this one, then circuit will be completed, a current will start to flow here. So due to the flow of the current in the coil here, as in this coil, suddenly the current will change, and that current will induces some induced EMF inside it. And just now we have studied through the self-inductance process, this EMF will be equal to minus L di by dt. So this experiment, this change in the current tells us that there will be the production of induced EMF. And suppose if in our coil there is R resistance, then through that you can understand there is the production of the current also. So that current will blow up this LED whenever we will just change this current here. So you have seen that whenever we are connecting the wire in experiment, LED blows up there. So this is the practical behavior and practical proof through which we can understand the process of self induction phenomena here. Next thing, where you are seeing again this kind of phenomena, like you have seen that in rainy season, suddenly when current changes, then sparks we are seeing, or somewhere when in short circuits, suddenly if current and voltage is changing, then some sparks are generated there. So that spark is due to the reason of self-inductance phenomena. So now let's see here the first next topic for the self-inductance phenomena. What is the self-inductance or coefficient of self-inductance, capital L, for the solenoid? So first let's see here the self-inductance of solenoid, and then we will see here the phenomena associated with the self-induction. So let's see first this term here. So for this term, we are going to understand self-induction in solenoid here. So as you know that solenoid is made up of the number of wires that is wounded over the soft iron core here. When such kind of magnetic materials we have taken and over which we have just wounded some of the wires in such a way, and in each wire current is flowing through any battery here that we have connected. So suppose I current is flowing here in these wires here, then you know that if there are a small number of turns per unit length of the wire, then for that case the magnetic flux, magnetic field produced inside the solenoid due to this behavior or this flow of the current, that is given by mu 0 Ni. So this is the magnetic field that is produced inside the solenoid due to the flow of the current in these n number of coils here. Next one here, as we know the magnetic field, then as these loops will have some of the area, then we can calculate with each loop what is the magnetic flux associated with it. So as with this loop you can see the magnetic flux will be associated here. So that magnetic flux with one loop only, that can be written, given by BA cos theta. So here if you will see the angle between magnetic field and this element of the area element, so area element that will be perpendicular to this one, the direction of the magnetic field here in this case. So as this is the perpendicular to the magnetic field, then this will be not perpendicular, as area vector is also in the same direction as the magnetic field, not perpendicular, sorry for that. So here this will be equal to 0 degree. So cos theta is 0, it means that here this will be equal to phi is equal to B A here. So now we can write down the value of B from here. So this will be equal to mu 0 N I, and also you can write the area of the one loop here. So as suppose the R is the radius of one loop, then area of one loop will be equal to phi R square from here. So clear, I think there is now no confusion in this section. Next one, as this is the flux linked with one coil, so in such a way we can calculate flux linked with the whole of the n number of coils here. So for this one, the net flux, suppose this was net flux phi n, we are going to write. So this phi n will be equal to mu 0 n I, if you want to write A, or if you want to write pi r square, no problem. So, and into, means flux in one coil into number of turns here in each coil. So as here you can see number of turns are, total number of turns are capital N. So here capital N will be equal to small n into L from here, if length of the solenoid is small l. So from here we can write in place of capital N, that is NL. So if we will multiply N into L here, that is equal to capital N, then it will provide you the flux link with whole of the coils that through which solenoid is made up of. Now we have calculated the net flux that is in linked with the whole of the entire of the solenoid here. So as Faraday concept gives rise to the phenomena of self-induction, so as whenever the current that is flowing through the solenoid, that will change. So that change in current will induces some of the self-inductance phenomena inside it. So that self-inductance phenomena, as you know, that is inducing an induced EMF, and that induced EMF is given by E is equal to minus L di by dt, and this is equal to E here, and also E is given by minus d phi by dt from here. So now you can just write down this one whole of the formula from here, means phi you can write. So if you will write phi from here, so this will be equal to minus d dt, and the value of phi, that is mu zero. Here if you will see, n will be multiplied here, the n square we will get, and also we will get from here pi r square l. These all terms are constant, exactly mu zero, n square, pi r square into l, these are constant. And I, as this is the key factor through which we are obtaining the self-inductance phenomena. So now we can take the all constant terms outside this one. So finally you can obtain from here minus L di by dt, this should be equal to minus times 0 n square pi r square L, and here di by dt. So here, as you can compare these two equations, so on comparing these two, we can calculate what is the self-inductance of the solenoid. So self-inductance L of the solenoid can be written as mu square n pi r square l from here. So this is the formula to calculate the self inductance of the coil. In place of pi r square, you can also write a here, so that will give rise to a little easy formula. So in this way you can understand easily all the formulas. So clear, I think, how can we calculate the value of the self inductance of solenoid here by this one. Now you can understand from here on which factor the self-inductance of the solenoid is depending on. So let's see that the factor on which it is depending on. So from here this formula we can again write in the way mu zero n square, this is pi r square, this is a, this is l here. Or if you want to write, so in the place of n, as you know that this n is capital N upon L. So from here you can write n square upon L square from here. So one L will cancel out from here. So this is mu zero n square A upon L from here, and this is capital L that we are getting. Now we can use this formula to understand on which factor the self-inductance is depending on. So first factor on which it is depending on, mu zero. So it is directly proportional to mu zero, means it is depending on the quality of the material, permeability of the material. So as you know that permeability tells us about the ability to penetrate inside the material through the magnetic field or through the for the change in magnetic flux. So greater will be the permeability of the medium, greater will be the self-inductance, reason there can be the greater change in the flux, so that we will get greater impact of the self-inductance phenomena. Second one, if we will increase the number of turns there, so as number is with each turn, there will be some flux attached with it. So for the greater number of turns, net flux will be increased, and due to that we will get large self-inductance property there. For the area, if we will increase the area of the loop, then with this factor we have studied before already, how can we produce the induced EMF. So by changing the area we can produce induced EMF, and if we are increasing area, induction is increasing. If we are decreasing the area, induction is decreasing. This phenomena as we have understood already. So it means here with change in area we can also change the self-inductance phenomena there, because it is changing the flux greatly there. Next one here is small l. This is the length of the solenoid. So greater will be the length of the solenoid, less will be there the induction phenomena. Because for the greater length, the coils will be at the greater distance. So all these things that opposes the induction one here. So that's why as the current will be reduced in this case, so the self-inductance phenomena will be reduced also. So clear, I think all upon which of the factor it is depending on the solenoid or cases here. So what is the induction or self-inductance in solenoid, and on which factor it is depending on, if we have to increase or reduce the inductance for the solenoid, then what we have to do. So we can apply all these concepts there to increase or decrease the inductance property there. So after the discussion on the self-inductance of solenoid, let's see our next topic here, that is the phenomena associated with the self-inductance. So here as for the phenomena that is associated with the self-induction process, that is first that we are seeing, that is sparking. So sparking, that is you can understand if you are just meeting two ends of the any like in experiment, I have just shown you that experiment, because this topic can be fully understood by this that experiment. So in the experiment, as we have seen that a sparkling effect we are seeing whenever the sudden change in the current we are seeing. So reason of the sparking is that whenever the current in the circuit that is changing, then the magnetic flux associated with the circuit that will change. So as the magnetic flux change in magnetic flux gives rise to a production of the induced EMF, and also it induces current inside it. So and due to that sudden production of the induced EMF and current, we are getting a sparking effect there. So that's why whenever there is the change in current, sudden change in current we are seeing, then for that case always we are seeing such kind of effect. Like you will see that kind of effect in bulb you can see, or the lights directly if you are just blowing off on you are doing on off on the switch, then that time you can understand this phenomena also. So means you have to change the flux and you can understand easily the production of the electromagnetic induction. Clear, I think. Next one here, the phenomena that is associated with it, that will that is here non-inductive binding. So in non-inductive binding, exactly here we are just decreasing the effect of the induction, and the because as you know that the greater will be the induction, then it will produce the greater eddy currents, and as eddy current somewhere it is undesirable, that loses the energy of the coil. So if we don't need the eddy currents in our circuit, we have to minimize it, then we have to reduce the induction phenomena there. So such kind of coils that we are making to reduce induction phenomena, that is called non-inductive winding. So let's see how we are just doing non-inductive winding here. So for the second one case, that is non-inductive winding. So to done this formula concept, as we are using it actually in post office box or resistance box. So in your lab you have already seen the post office box and resistance box. If you haven't seen, then you will see in experiment lab also then this year. So here as if you will see in resistance box, there are the gap between two here keys and the two coils here that are attached, and in between we are just putting some of the tapping key here, so that can fill up this gap and that can complete the circuit, so that we are using this kind of spacing phenomena to just complete the circuit in resistance box to apply different resistances, or in post office box to also apply the different resistances. So this is very helpful for us, and in the same way we are using in tapping key, in keys here, this kind of theory. So here as we are just attaching some of the wire with these two metals so that circuit can be completed. So here for the wire here, we are not using two different wires and we are not connecting them to just we are using single wire here, and we are doing the coiling of that single wire in such a way such kind of coiling we are doing here. So if you will see this kind of attachment we are doing for this one, means single wire, you have seen that with the help of single wire I have made such kind of winding of the coil. So we are not using actually this kind of thing. I think the figure is not clear, that's why I am just moving it down. This can time you can see the figure now. So as you have seen it, then next one case here, as for this kind of winding, let's just make it again. Actually I will draw this one again. So for this one, as we have two coils here and one tapping key I just have. So for this one, as one of the wire I have just made here, and for this one some such kind of coiling we have seen, and as this is attached at this port. So here circuit is completed already. Whenever we will just tap this key here, so due to the tapping of the key, circuit will be completed, a current will flow through these wires. So as you know that this current, as number of coiling we have seen, so eddy currents will be produced here. But here one thing, the in one wire, as the direction of coiling is opposite to the other one, so the direction of current in both of these two coils that are in different direction, means in this one coil through which we have making this one, so in this one as current, if it is in this direction, then in opposite one when we are just reducing this one and we have connected with this here, so here this is in opposite direction. So as the length of the coil are same, but current are inducing at in these two coils in opposite direction, so they will cancel out each other. Means here simple thing I just want to make you explain, by using such kind of coiling exactly, we are just cancelling out the induced EMF effect with each other. So as in one coil current will be in this direction, then in another coil it will be in opposite direction, they will cancel out each other, and in this way we can make non inductive coil here easily. Means we can reduce the inductive effect. So that inductive effect, if it is reduced, no eddy currents will be produced here, no, there is a loss of current there. So clear, I think loss of energy we will not get there. So as students, this is now just clear. And one more things we can understand here, as electrostatic shielding. So electrostatic shielding effect I have told you already by using the eddy currents concept. So as in yesterday class, number of application of eddy currents we have seen there, electrostatic shielding concept I have told you already. So these are the phenomena that are associated with the self induction process. So as today we have just completed all the topics related to the self induction. So I think student, about this all the things are now clear. So in next class we will see mutual inductance. So let's just see that in next class. For today, let's end our class here. Thank you, students.